Welcome to Raya Guru. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create capacity planning in Rally. So if you're new to this channel, consider subscribing and pressing bell icon for more updates. So before proceeding further, we need to understand what you will get it from this video. So I will cover it up here. What is capacity planning? How to do capacity planning? How to plan before BI? Creating draft plan and publish it to team with practical demo. So whenever you are logging with Rally login credential, you're able to see this home screen where you have to select your project where you want to add your capacity planning. So right now I'm working on workspace 1 and inside this I'm selecting demo project. Post that. For doing capacity planning, we have to go to portfolio items and click on capacity planning. From here, you're able to see different capacity plannings are already done. If you can see here, right now it's in the draft state and whatever I've published is available for everyone to view it. Those who is having permission to view can see the capacity planning in detail. So first of all, what is capacity planning? Facilities that events loading up to big room planning, create what if scenarios and plan inside the Rally without changing artifacts and execution data for teams projects. Capacity planning provides the ability to model backlogs, teams capacity and portfolio items to team allocation for a given release or a start and end release. It enables product and engineering management to bring the right work into the room for release planning, where management can focus on dependencies and risk conversation instead of what will be accomplished. Plans are not user specific. Any changes we make to an unpublished plan can be viewed by other planners. Only published plan can be viewed by all users. Any associations or allocations of feature to teams made in unpublished plan to change any other values in Rally. Planners such as executive program manager, product manager, development managers, product owners, release, trained engineers and team leads can all benefit from capacity planning. So not everyone can plan it. Those who is having permission to do the planning can only be able to make the capacity plan ready. So if your login credential is having this checked in, then only you can plan it for capacity planning. Now working with the capacity plan, a plan represents set of portfolio items which is teams or specified time frames. We can also call it as a release. Since all items in a portfolio may not have a refined estimates, which is available as estimates, which is not yet finalized with everyone. So once it is refined, it means ready to publish it with everyone permission can be published for everyone. We need to have at least a preliminary estimates on the portfolio items. The initial capacity plan calculation is based on the preliminary estimates until refined estimates are determined. This allows you to determine the initial portfolio backlogs cut line. Once a refined estimates is available, the capacity plan is calculated based on the refined estimates. So let me show you. When you click on the portfolio items, from there you will find it out different feature. So not all features is having refined estimates unless and until it is not agreed with everyone. So from here you'll find it out its preliminary estimates and refined estimates will be entered when everyone is ready to go ahead. You can see here, this is the refined estimates. Now let's go to the capacity planning, and here I'm creating a capacity planning draft report. So this is my capacity plan demo click on add plan. Once you click on add plan, the capacity plan name is ready for you, and here we have not initiated start release and end release, which we can enter it after going inside it. So right now I'm selecting just features, but you can also select any of the items which is available here, that is initiatives, epics and everything. For start release, you can select any of the releases which you are looking forward to complete it, or start date and complete in this release cycle only. So this is the start release and end release streets, where you can find it out inside your release items. If you want to make more space, you can just click on backward or forward arrow from here. If you want to add portfolio items, you can select it from here. You'll find it out all the features are available here, which you can select it by one or directly selecting from here. Here you will find it out show filter options, where you can add the filter based on your states or preliminary estimates or some other reasons as well. Like if you want to filter with the date, you have to search it and you can select the date filter as well. You can also add preliminary estimates with their values like this and select on these filters. So if you want to select any specific items, you can find out medium sizes are available, but as of now I want to select each and every features to be available inside my capacity plan. So I've selected each and every feature here. The parent name is available here, the project details is available here. If you want to mark as a rank to define the priority of the feature, you can also do it. Post that, click on add to plan, and all these features are available here. From here you can add your teams. So right now I'm selecting three teams here, but you can select any of the teams plan as per your need. Capacity is basically how much capacity your team is having. So let's say my demo or project team is having capacity of 230 hours in a week. This one I'm having only 130, and this one I'm having 100. It means total capacity of all my three teams is 360 plus 100, that is 460 hours in a week. Here, if you want to edit any of the items, simply click on edit and you're able to edit any of the options while adding or removing it. Now, here you will find it out blue bars. So blue bars is indicating whatever you have committed is showing on top, on upper section of this bar, and whatever you have not committed it is showing on lower section of your bar. At any point of time, you can drag and drop any of the items to add it into the commits section. If you want to edit any of the options, you can just simply click on edit and you're able to edit this item. If you want to see summary of your team members, you can simply click on summary and see it. Unless until you're not able to, you will not publish, this item will no more available for all your team members. Those who are having a permission of management can view it, or permission of planner can view it. Now, this is my contents which is lying inside it. Let me drag and drop each of the items to view it. And sometimes you will find it out different color codes which defines the items or team members who are working on it. So now you can see it's 9% loaded, 14%, you can see it's increasing. Unless and until your team is not overloaded, it will not become a red height mark. Right now it's in the safe, because of that it's showing green items. Let me drag and drop to the lower section, and we can change this one. I am adding it to team 3. Again, I'm adding it to team 2. Now, all my items are right now added. So, if you have n number of items, you can search it from the search box and you can plan it accordingly. So, till now, you have team 3 is loaded with 39%, which is not overloaded capacity of your team. It's in the safe mode. Let's say if you want to allocate some of your tasks to the other team members, we can also do it. Right now it's assigned to testing, where you are highlighting here 4 hours of your testing. You can add and remove your teams from here on clicking minus icon to remove it and plus icon to add new team members. And rest of the timings I am giving here as a. And now this option is split into two parts, where one is added to this demo sessions. So if, let's say, in one features two teams are working or three teams are working, you can segregate it accordingly. So post your all these details are ready, you can see all the timings. If you want to see more detail about your capacities and feature details, you can find it out, where you can see name, dependencies. If dependencies are available, you can see one highlighted here, otherwise it is showing 0. Leaf story rollout points are added here, group estimates, preliminary estimates, and if you have any refined estimates, you can also see it from here. Same thing is applicable for your other team members. You can see it. Post that if you want to see the complete summary of your capacity. You can find it out. This is the cut line which you can see it for your team members. It means this is the committed state, but instead of that, you can add, you are adding or covering these 4 features as well. So once you have refined estimates and all the estimates are added completely, you will find it out the complete percentage here. So right now it's not having the complete estimation detail. Because of that, it's not showing with the percentage. So this is up. If you want to print it and share with your other team members, you can directly print it and save it in the preview file or share with others as well. So now, if you are confident enough and everyone is ready with this plan, you can publish it so others can view the complete details. Who is having view permissions? At any point of time, if you want to edit it, you can copy and paste it and make the editable plan and publish it to again. So that is how we are doing capacity planning in Rally. Hope you liked it. If you really enjoyed the session and thinking about this valuable insight about Rally and capacity plan, share within your circle so that others can also get benefited with this video. Thank you for watching.